Ozone. Street Dancer.
The 80s is a time fondly remembered for neon lycra, permed mullets, and oversized shoulder pads. But it's also a time remembered for giving us some of the most iconic dance movies of all time. From Dirty Dancing to Footloose, Flashdance to Staying Alive, cheesy dance flicks don't get much better than this. But one film captured the spirit of the 1980s perhaps better than any other, one which may not receive huge critical acclaim, but was a hit with audiences and would live in the hearts of fans forever. Breakin was a film both inspired by and influential to the 1980s breakdance phenomenon, telling the story of a breakdance duo and one classically trained dancer's attempts to become a street dancer. Released in 1984 by Canon Films, the production group which came to be known for its high volume of low-budget action blockbusters, Breakin was one of the company's most successful releases, making $38,682,000 at the box office. And while Breakin hasn't gone down in history with the same legendary status as, say, Dirty Dancing, it's no doubt a hidden gem from that golden age of dance movies. So why has this film with a low budget, awkward dialogue, and amateur actors stood the test of time? Well, Breakin was released when breakdancing was at peak popularity, when hip-hop, funk, and soul music was thriving. It was inspired by a 1983 documentary called Breakin' and Entering, about the hip-hop and b-boy scene of Los Angeles, which featured several of Breakin's main actors, including Michael Boogaloo Shrimp Chambers, Adolfo, Shabba Doo, Quiñones, and even a young Ice-T. And what makes Breakin so special is this real-life influence, taking real talent who lived and breathed dance and venturing into their world. These weren't actors who could dance. They were dancers who were asked to act. Shabba Doo was an innovator in the dance style of locking, which consisted of freezing and locking from fast movements. He was an original member of the American dance music show Soul Train and went on to found the dance group The Lockers. He's also choreographed for artists including Lionel Richie, Madonna, and Luther Vandross. And it was in pursuing a career in dance that landed him a job choreographing Lionel Richie's All Night Long music video, which featured none other than his Breakin' co-star Boogaloo Shrimp. After featuring in the All Night Long video, Shrimp also appeared alongside Shabba Doo in Chaka Khan's music video for I Feel For You, and went on to perform the dancing that was used to develop the MC Scat Cat animation in Paula Abdul's Opposites Attract music video. And he's even said to be the original inventor of the moonwalk. Boogaloo Shrimp became known for his popping style, inspired by Ray Harryhausen's stop-motion graphics in old films. Shrimp's popping nicely complemented Shabba Doo's locking, and together they were the unstoppable duo of Turbo and Ozone. Ozone is smooth, sharp, and quick-witted, while Turbo is young, lively, and immature. Shabba Doo described them as the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis of hip-hop, and together they have all the ingredients for the perfect lovable pair. Their scenes together showcase some of the best moves you will see in any dance movie, from Venice Beach, featuring a young Jean-Claude Van Damme, to dance battles, to the stage. Each performance is equally raw, passionate, and unfiltered, but out of every scene in the film, fans look back with wonder and amazement on one performance in particular. The broom dance is one of the most iconic scenes in Breakin' the movie, bursting with creativity, style, and passion, with a certain magic touch. Any fan of the film knows the pure wonder and amazement of this dance, a showcase of Boogaloo Shrimp's raw natural talent. Thrown into this crazy world of breakdancing is the classically trained dancer Kelly, played by Lucinda Dickey. Kelly finds herself out of her depth when she's mentored by Turbo and Ozone in order to beat a rival street group. Through this process, we're graced with one of the best 80s montage sequences of all time, one that could even give Rocky a run for its money.
You can teach me.
We're asking for trouble. Man, now I know we're in trouble.
Breakin' has managed such a strong hold on fans over the years because the music captures a time that is filled with nostalgia for many. This, paired with the natural talent of every dancer, is why the dance scenes make up for some of the weaker aspects of the film. And it's not just the breakdancing that's mesmerising. The scenes where Kelly dances in Franco's studio are just as impassioned with songs that were tragically never officially released. But if there's one scene that perfectly encompasses all of the heart, soul, and passion that drives this film, it's the audition scene. The trio find out they can't audition for a new show when Franco tells the directors that they aren't classic dancers. Angered and brimming with determination, Ozone storms onto the stage as the music starts up. What we witness here is the complete and utter love for dance possessed by each dancer that exists outside of the film, as well as within. That spinning camera speaks volumes of the emotions of the characters in this scene, more than any scripted words could have. The 80s is fondly remembered as a decade for iconic films. But for every classic, there were dozens of cheesy B-movies that didn't stand the test of time. But despite being the punchline of many jokes and having all the ingredients for failure, Breakin defied the critics and achieved cult status even when all the odds were against it. But besides the fact it's a quintessentially 80s nostalgia trip, one thing keeps this film alive all these years later. The fans. Breakin ignited a fire in breakdance enthusiasts all those years ago, which continues to burn today. And while it may not have been as polished and as clean as other dance films from that era, it had three things that allowed it to stand a chance. Talent, heart, and soul. Breakin may be hidden from the mainstream, but this gem continues to shine three decades on.